Hey guys, Xander here from Fire Rocker Studios, and today we are in Minecraft 1.8, and I'm going to be showing you guys how to customize the brand new armor stands. I'm also going to show you how to make them fly, how to make them walk, and a bunch of other cool, neat little tricks using all the new features, well, not all the new features, but at least some of the new features with the command blocks in the 1.8 update. Now, if you guys enjoy this video, or at least would like to see me do more 1.8 tutorial videos showing you guys how to do pretty cool little contraptions or tricks and the new update, make sure to give this video a like. If we get more than 500 likes, I will go ahead and keep doing my research and try to find neat little contraptions or just cool commands that you guys could easily do. And yeah, also, all the commands that I'm going to be showing you guys today are in the description below, so if you guys want to copy and paste them into your very own command blocks and put them as features in your map or whatever it is, make sure to scroll down in the description below and you can just copy and paste them. They're all right in there. And yeah, so let's go ahead and get started. So here are some of the basic ones. I actually set them all out way over here, and they actually are pretty freaking awesome. So this is the very first one. It is an armor stand with its arms forward. Now here is the command right over here, so I'm going to slide right through it so you guys can see. It's basically the slash summon command, and then you've got armor stands, so it's got show arms, and then the pose, and then the left arm, and the right arm, and it's pretty simple when you actually think about it. Now of course, if I go ahead and let's use chainmail armor because it's semi see-through in a sense, and let's go ahead and show you how it looks with the actual armor on. So I put this one in twice. Let me get the pants right now, and there you go. That gives you an idea of how it looks. So the arms kind of are weird because of course they're leaning forward, but it is still pretty cool, especially when you add motion to some of these. Now this one over here is one that moves, so I'll wait a little bit to show you guys that one. But let me know in the comment section down below, what do you think about the armor stand with its arms moving forward? Let me know in the comment section down below, and let me know which is your favorite out of all the armor stands that I'm going to show you today. So this one is just one that's rotated a little bit when you spawn it, nothing really too special to that. Let me go ahead and get you another armor stand. This is just the default one, so I should probably show this one first. Here is the default armor stand. Nothing too special about it. It's just that. Here is just spawning it so you can rotate it. You could change this and customize it. So if you ever wanted to get an exact position while spawning it, because of course, depending where you look is where it will spawn. But yeah, next one. This is actually one of my favorites, and this is one with big arms. So the command is right in here. It's very simple. It is slash summon space armor stand, and then show arms, and then just one. So yeah, it is as simple as that. Now, how does it look when you actually put armor on it? It actually looks pretty freaking cool. So if I go ahead and get everything inside, you can see the arms completely go down, which is, in my opinion, better than this one because the arms are forward, but that still does look pretty cool. And of course, the default ones don't even have arms. So guys, let me know in the comment section down below, what do you guys think about the armor stands with arms? Would you guys prefer them to have arms or prefer them to have no arms? Let me know in the comment section down below. Now, this one is actually another one of my favorites. It is the invisible armor stand. So slash summon space armor stands, and then you just do invisible one. And yeah, so it is literally as simple as that. I can even go ahead and put a helmet on so you can see how it looks, and I'll put the pants on too. So yeah, it's an invisible armor stand. You can't actually see it. So for people that have been wondering, when you see a moving armor stand coming at you but you don't actually see the body of it, or at least the armor stand in general, it's because it is invisible, but it's still pretty neat to see. Now these next ones are actually gonna be pretty cool. I believe these ones actually don't have anything because I ran out of stuff to put in them because I couldn't find any other ones. But over here we're gonna have some neat ones. So let me finish up with the last customized armor stand, and this one has the arms forward. How does it look? This one's a little bit more complicated than the other ones, not that much more, but it's just slash summon, and then you got the armor stand, and then you got the right arm, and then you've got just weird stuff wearing the same thing with the left, and of course show arms. So yeah, and this is how it looks when I go ahead and add armor to it. It's a little bit weird because of course the arms are sticking right forward, but I believe that the armor, actually, wow, I just realized the armor does move with the arms a little bit. That's pretty cool. Whereas with this one, well, actually, they do it with this one too. I never really realized that. So the armor kind of does move with the arms. They don't just stick right through. I never realized that. I just realized that now. I feel like a noob now. But yeah, that's actually pretty neat. That makes it look way cooler. Holy crap. Wow, let me know, guys, in the comment section down below. What did you guys think about that? I just realized that now. So But this is going to get pretty interesting. So the first one I'm going to show you is moving armor stance. So this one is a pretty neat one over here. It's actually, I think it's got the entity of a silverfish, as I just saw right over there. And it's basically got the show arms command. So let me go ahead and spawn this one in. So you've got an armor stand. It's only got the boots. It's got diamond boots and it's got a diamond sword. And again, it's got the entity of a silverfish. So that is why you can see the silverfish, or hear the silverfish, not actually see it. Oh, let me actually make it daytime so you guys can see everything really clear. But yeah, so that is how you get a moving armor stand. Of course, I believe if you were to give it the entity of, I think, a zombie, it would look a lot cooler. And of course, if you were to make the armor stand invisible and it was just armor, that's how you can get like an invisible looking character chasing you. Now, this one over here is going to be pretty cool. So if I go ahead and scroll through this command, you can see this one actually uses the bat entity. So you can probably get an idea of how this is gonna look the second I spawn it in. And there you go! It is a flying armor stand! Of course, it would look way cooler if you could make the armor stand invisible, and then you could put arms like that one, or like, really any of the other really cool ones that I showed you today, because then just be a flying body. And of course, if you- I don't know if you could make it mixed with another mob that is hostile, but hey, if you guys are good with command blocks and you could take some of these commands and customize it yourselves, then I'm interested in seeing what you guys can make. Leave a comment down below on what crazy contraptions could you make yourself using these commands and using the armor stands. But yeah, that is the flying one, and I'll go ahead and wrap it up with the final one over here, which this one has a weird head to it, but basically if I go through it right here, you can see that what it does is it just has a custom head. And yeah, it's basically a mob. It'll go around and it's got the custom head. It's got the cool arms in the bottom. The head isn't working for some reason. I don't know. Maybe it has to be on the server or something. But yeah. That's pretty much it for that. And yeah, you could also put custom heads on these stands for people that weren't wondering. So I can get the, let me just type in skull. I can put a wither skull on one of these, which instantly makes them look way cooler than if it was just the normal thing. So yeah, that's how you can make really cool custom armor stands and just in general, really cool contraptions with these. And they really help, especially if you're making a custom map and you want to have like really cool boss. And there's so much more that you could do with this. You can make it so the armor stands have more motion to them. Again, I don't know exactly how to do all of that stuff. I wanted to show you guys the basics first, but if you guys enjoy this and you would like to see a more advanced version of this video, maybe I show you guys how to make it have motion and other cool customization stuff, let me know in the comment section down below. I will do my research and try to find even more commands and other tricks on making this even cooler. But yeah guys, leave a like if you enjoyed this video, show your support in the comment section down below, subscribe to my channel if you haven't already. Like always, I'm Andrew from Fire Rocker Studios, and you guys are rockers, and here is the very long outro. Hey, did you enjoy this video? I really hope you did, and if you want to stay up to date with all the videos that I post, because I post literally every single day on all three of my channels, you better follow me. It is at FRZWorld, that is my Twitter and my Instagram, it's right here on the top right of this little screen. And of course, I have my vlogging channel, which is FRZWorld, where I post daily videos, as well as Andrew vs. Games, where I post game videos like, you know, GTA and Goat Simulator and Battlefield and all those thingies. And right below that is Fire Rocker Studios, which is my main channel where I post 2 to 3 videos a day, every single day. That's also the same as my Twitch, which is twitch.tv/FireRockerStudios. I actually took the time to annotate this for you, so hurry up and click those links. Now, if you're on a mobile device and you don't have annotations turned on, if you go to the description of this video, you will find all the links to all my 3 channels, plus my Twitter and my Instagram and my Twitch, so you have no reason to not follow them or subscribe to them. So you better do that now. And also, if you haven't already, give this video a like. Of course, only if you want to. I wouldn't want to force you to do anything. But you better do that because, you know, it shows that you're awesome. And subscribe to all of my channels. Because if you haven't, then you won't be getting updates. Like, come on, you gotta subscribe and follow me on Twitch, man. Because I stream on there at least 3 to 4 times a week. I try. I mean, my schedule's up there. So, yeah, pretty much, if you want to stay up to date with everything that I do, you better follow me on Twitter, at FRZWorld, because I tweet all the time, literally all the time. So, follow me there, guys, and yeah, you actually watched to this point, like, the video's over. You can go now, go watch my other videos, like, literally on the top left, if you're on the computer, like, and have annotations on, I put a back and a next video, so go watch other videos. You know, you could do that now. You could subscribe too if you haven't already, but like, if you haven't already, like, what are you waiting for? Like, subscribe. Come on. Do it. Did you do it? Good. Good. Now, go watch another video. Bye. I'm gonna roll the music now, because this is just getting weird.